at?
He's there somewhere.
We're offline just a second. We're going back online right now. Like, for like 5 seconds from now.
Just wait a second, yeah.
Sweet.
All right, now you go.
Random gamer dude, where you at? Thanks for having on our backs.
Yeah, he was there. He was definitely rooting for you guys.
He was with us in spirit. I'm down for a Kumite.
Yeah, let's do it.
I'm down for that all day. Are you guys leaving Guilty Gear?
What's the next game? All right, Unio's coming up. I'm going to let someone else in the mic. Good luck with Faust.
Oh, yeah. There's...
Hey, it's the N for US. I'm on the mic because no one else is really around. So we are starting Unio on stream. First up, we got TT Warrior versus Blackout. Blackout with Vault Sight, TT Warrior Blue Nank. Tries to rush in, gets a clap. No, she dashes back. Powering up is GRD. He's rushing it down, but oh no! Catch him with the wall slam. Now he's got a setup right here. Has to be careful. All right, nice lockdown. Oh! Got the hit. There she gets the throw. Yeah, she does a short jump into it. He needs to drop it. Bossy just keeping classy, but now he gets thrown. Oh, he's got the combo. Nice. No, dropped it. There's a jump in to clap. Oh, there's a throw. He's gonna cancel it. Yep. Yeah, there you go. That should kill. Yep. Oh, a little bit left. It was barely. Trying to do the ultimate. No. What's gonna happen? Allsign takes that. Here's the medical. Oh, nice jump in to the super throw. Oh, no, not enough to cancel, but he's got it locked down. Ah, no air combo. Now she's getting in there. All right, she got the launcher. But then her slice of super. Oh, very nice cancel right there. Oh, charging up. If she cancels, doesn't get anything out of it. Slice stuff in, but it falls out. She's got to be really careful right now. Oh, there it is. Yep. That jumping tick grab. Blackout takes game one. Yo. Yo, yo, get a commentary, dude. All right, I'm being joined by Manami.
I am drunk and I am commentating.
Yeah, man. And you're right. And you're running at the same time.
I'm running the bracket too.
Yeah.
CT Warriors playing Blackout right now.
Yeah, man.
I don't even know what this matchup is like.
It's gonna be kind of tough for Wallstein, but Blackout won game one, so.
But Wallstein's is higher on the tier list, so.
Yeah.
I think he's better. Oh wow! Oh. What a conversion.
Nice cancel like that.
Nice combo right there. He's gonna finish it right here. Yeah. That's a good first round.
Yo, he's running it back.
This is the first game, right?
No, this is the second game because Blackout won the first one.
Oh, he did? Yeah. Wow.
So he's angry, dude. He's like, no, fuck that.
Let's come back. He's already downloading him.
Yeah, he's getting his combos. He was dropping
EX
a lot.
EX Kuga?
Oh, dang.
All right, so he wakes up with EX DP.
Yeah,
it's not that good of a wake-up option, but, you know, sometimes you just gotta do it.
Well, situation. Oh, opens the box.
So he's got the Mujin combo, but he drops it. Steps up. Oh, 4B.
Is he gonna cancel? Is he gets it up to cancel?
No, he's got corner pressure now.
Yep. Oh! Yo, fuck the cancel. Just grab her. All right. Yo, it's 1-1.
It's 1-1 right
1-1.
Now.
All right.
Hey, get the fuck out of here, Elric. I'm taking over.
Do my homeboy told
Yo, my nigga, what up? Yo, who's this skinny-ass Asian nigga playing Lin? Oh, CT Warrior. I haven't seen that nigga since Melty. What the fuck?
Yep, he's back, dude. He's back.
Yo.
He's back. And he's ready
Yo,
to
my
play.
Real question is this school know how to fight Wald, though? Because that's a switching. Because this fucking, this great Wald, Tommy, is going fucking ham right now. Here comes Oki. Didn't DP out of it or did anything?
Oh, he whipped his DP.
Oh, get snatched. Change shift. This ain't gonna kill. He could get him in a setup though. Oh, he did not know what to do.
I'm gonna play beneath on
Down.
Stream. Tell him.
Round one. Round two now.
Yeah.
Blackout taking that pretty convincingly.
Yeah.
EX Kuga goes in. Assault, my favorite button in this game. Gets nothing. Here we go, Lin. You're being careful. She's scared of getting touched because one wall touch leads into a vortex. You're gonna die. Change shift, grab. There we go. This is where it starts. Oh, the net play. Change shift, throw. Runs in, gets a throw. 2A, the low, down. I don't know what the score is, but whatever. Yo, screw these wall normals. Too wide. Oh, here we go. Gets a combo going, drops it. Super, whatever. Gets hit. Lin with the momentum.
Oh, he blocks
oh,
himself.
No! Get snatched!
Oh my god!
Change shift? He is not in the girl leads. He is not gonna have change shift next. But will
Woo!
He eat
it? Nice.
Lin has change shift, burns it right now, gets hit.
Oh.
Kuga!
This is the comeback right here.
Gets combo. You have this one chance. You have to make something of it. Assault.
It doesn't go through. Wait,
gets blocked, gets a low.
The 2C.
Oh shit, he dropped it.
Get it!
Oh.
Wait it patiently!
All that
Gets
damage!
Gets a throw!
All the damage!
I'm not A4US, switch my name! There we go. What up, y'all?
My knob is drunk as fuck.
I'm good, don't worry about it. Clark is like out of it. Clark
is gone. This fool. This fool became a free sample. Like, just gone.
Clark, get over there and play your fucking match.
Play your match. Don't fucking trip over the court.
Yo, Manabe is drunk as shit.
Yo, we're going to restart the stream.
AJ's going to restart the stream real quick. We'll be right back.
Not the stream, but the recording. The recording, okay.
Whatever it is.
We good then. Sup?
What up? So how good is Clark when he plays games while drunk is what I want to know.
This fool does, like, the most random shit when he's drunk. I am hella looking forward to this.
Yo, Kelly Burst, I was, like, hammered as shit. I somehow placed top 8. That was pretty great.
Is this the new power-up? You got to get turned up in order to win?
Bro, that's been the power-up.
Oh, shit, you're right.
You don't go to many majors, do you?
No,
shit.
I don't. Fuck.
This nigga got the nerve to wear a Hitler shirt on the stream.
The fuck? Who's wearing a goddamn Hitler shirt?
Clark, that's, like... Her name is Adolf. That's like Moy Hitler.
Names,
or
her name's what the fuck? Her name's Adolf. Yo,
I don't fucking. Yo, Brett's alive. Holy shit.
Oh shit, he's alive. Fucking Jew Baker is a fucking blonde. What the hell is this?
Hey yo, where is CT? Where'd CT go?
CT's dead. We're playing CP
2.0. Yo, CT. Bell says your ass. Your ass, according to Bell.
Oh,
listen,
shit.
Why don't you just listen to him? You might become a top player that way. Who knows?
You might become a top player. Holy shit.
But as you are right now, your ass. I'll believe Bell.
That face. That face. This guy's so done. He's so done. Yo.
Clark, wake up. You got to play Ugum, dog.
This is the start of Ugum. Yo, this fool's gone. Shit's an easy bake.
Hey, yo, real talk. Better Clark than Vineeth. Better Clark drunk than Vineeth.
Yo, Vineeth burst. You don't understand. The car ride back. Vineeth burst. That was the worst burst ever. I had to get dry cleaning.
All right, so for those of you who don't know, Clark had like, he had like a shot. He had a shot of Fireball and the rest was Rim Chata.
What the fuck?
And then he had one shot of gin. And then apparently Judge gave him whiskey. I don't know how much.
That was a mistake.
All of it?
Where the fuck Judge at? Where is Judge?
Okay, the match is starting.
Where is Judge? Because I had to get out white people for enforcing bad behavior. Now this match is starting, and somehow Nanase is fucking up for
what? A combo? Oh shit! Oh my god! Is this how it starts?
It's Ebony Nanase. Why is it Nanase? He plays Elgnum.
Yo,
Vineeth does not know what's
happening. I think I know what happened.
Okay, but. Vineeth has, like, gathered his bearings here.
I think Clark thought he picked Line, so he's fucking doing air Kugas and shit.
Either way, Vineeth got his footing on his...
That boss butt!
Wait, you ain't gonna tell me this is a button check, dog.
This ain't a button check.
Get out of here. Snake Oki's... Okay.
Who the fuck? Oh, the mix-ups! Get chewed! Oh, shake the baby! Oh! That hold!
Good barrel!
That barrel! No, oh, that went up! Net play! 100% 5-star net play! 100%
Clark is
that
Clark
shield!
Is done. He's this is terrible!
Oh shit, he's got hits!
Chewing. What the fuck?
No! Nigga, that's a drop match! That's not a fucking bun check, that's one up Vineeth! That's one up beneath.
He won.
Yo, what the hell are you doing, dog?
He's like, I lost the first round. I'm done. Does this fool play high? I don't even know.
Clark's not even playing high. He's just holding a stick. He's not even hitting buttons right now. He's just like, what?
He's fucking holding the wine glass and mashing and shit.
Yo, Hyde ain't looking that nice right now. Oh wow.
Damn. Break. Oh, my God. Yomi. Can you call this Yomi if you don't know what you're pressing?
There's not much you can do with Hyde. You just, like, do shit.
You just mash. Oh, shit. DPs. There ain't no DP anymore. Ain't no DP no more.
Dog, you need to stop. Anyway, folks, welcome to NorCal Dogfight. We brought some alcohol, niggas got turned, and this is the result.
My man, my sheriff.
You see some really, really bad matches.
Taking a selfie. Oh, my God. Actual damage. Actual mix-up.
Real talk, this isn't even a match, so I'm just going to comment on how lost Clark looks right now. He's just like... Clark is literally like spacing out and laughing right now. He's just like, what's going on?
This feels like I press buttons.
You can't do that. Bruh.
This is like what happened.
Stop. He's giving up. Wait, who's running this bracket now?
He's done.
Who's in charge of this bracket right now?
Drunk ass nigga over here. He is.
Clark, are you still doing the bracket?
Fuck that shit.
What the fuck? What the fuck? My money.
My money.
That just happened.
That just fucking happened.
He almost took a round.
He played Nanase like it was fucking Lean A. Throwing shit like it's a Kuga. To be fair, he shield broke beneath while being that completely out. Worst match ever. Jesus.
Best match ever.
Who's the next match? I don't even fucking know.
I'm not sure. I think Black Mage has it or Orion has it.
Someone has a rectangular piece of technology that has the bracket.
One of them has it. Brett looks so unamused.
Yeah.
This is a great thing to wake up to, right?
This is a very professional.
For those of you
tournament.
Who don't know, Brett was like out like 4 hours.
Combo video. He was filming a combo video.
He was like dead on the Game Center couch. And he wakes up to see like drunk matches happening. And like not even CO knows what they're doing.
That was real, by the way. That is going through the bracket. So much turn up, everyone's done.
Oh man, what up? Who's running the bracket?
Who is running the bracket? Black Mage. Black Mage has the bracket.
Okay, Black Mage has the bracket.
Yeah.
So
we're not dead.
I'll be back.
All right. Oh shit. It's this guy.
What you want, though?
What's up? I'm here to play golf. How about you?
Where's your golf? I was watching Keenan do it earlier.
The main event. I've been calling it the main event. Apparently there's side bets for whether Ernest or myself is gonna win.
And what are the odds?
What? No one's gonna take up my side.
That's the thing. No one will. Because it's earnest.
The only person that I can believe in is Koo.
You're even betting. What are you talking about?
Weren't you betting?
I'm betting on 2K to win this whole thing. Fuck Team Black People.
Fuck Team Black People.
I'm trying to get money.
Wow. So we got Joss and Apology Man coming up. Actual match.
So Merkava versus
Hilda.
Yeah, I lost to him earlier.
Joss is fundamentally pretty solid player.
Oh, he puts in a lot of work. Good.
He puts in a lot of work during like the downtime, during like general like times when this place is open.
Yeah.
He'll just solo grind the entire night.
Oh damn.
He'll match up people that just happen to show up. So I feel like he has a great grasp on how he plays his character.
Mm-hmm.
He tends to doubt himself from time to time, but I don't think he should.
He showed me earlier he doesn't need a DP.
Yeah, you don't need a DP. If you know how to play fundamentally solid and you're patient enough, you know when to shield correctly. Even if Hilda is like dicks when she's getting, you know, like humped on,
yeah,
you're okay.
She's fine.
Yeah.
The only thing that she lacks is DP. If she had a DP, I would hate fighting her forever.
If she was a DP, then we're playing fucking new in CT all over again.
Oh, yeah. Gravity Well?
Gravity Well. Fucking Blast Back.
My favorite thing is that it doesn't have Throw and Bone.
No Throw and Bone. Okay.
All right.
So they already button checked, so we're going straight into it.
All right.
I don't know that much about Merkava because I haven't seen Beneath play Merkava.
Merkava does whatever he wants.
Yeah. Fly
like
up.
That.
Super punishable when he flies up there, but I don't know if Hilda actually has something that can really hit him when he's up there. But now that he's in, Hilda really has to be really patient. Yeah.
Fly.
Good block. No shields.
Overhead.
Oh,
he tried throwing. He tried to throw.
Shake the baby straight up into this combo.
Mess up the combo, but it doesn't matter. No attack.
One more mix-up will do it. Oh.
Hit low.
That's probably
low.
It, actually, yeah. Oh, don't let him drink. Don't let him drink.
He's going in. Oh, my God. Why? Anyways.
Don't let Clark drink.
Overhead with
Take
Clark,
that shit
matter.
Away from him.
Oh, he's going in. In.
Solid.
Okay.
Where's he gonna go?
Oh. Cross up, overhead block.
Cross up.
Not shielded though, so he's able to go. He's flowing.
Yep. Shielding is pretty difficult on reaction though for
True.
Some people. So unless you play Marvel.
So, I don't know. Beneath plays Marvel. He might need a shield.
What? Then he's just being a squirrel.
True.
Oh, slappy hands. Slap boxing. EX slap box.
Oh, messes up the combo. Overhead. Blocks.
Throws that projectile.
Overhead in the air.
No overhead. Okay.
Anti-air overhead.
I don't know if jumping against Merkava. Oh, nice, very nice veil. What's set up? Caught him.
Is he gonna go?
Caught him jumping.
Is
or trying to back dash?
Yes.
There you go.
Work.
That's gonna land. Hey, he's done. He's done. Boom.
All the swords. And then there's Beneath.
Look at Joss's face. He looks so focused. He was like, I didn't really want to use that much meter, but you know what? I got me the kill at the end.
He has to use meter anyways.
Yep.
It's going to go out.
Oh, right. He did veil. So.
Yeah. Good anti-air.
Drops the pickup on that.
I don't know what he's supposed to do for the pickup. He did 5A there.
Yeah.
Pretty sure he does. Got sick.
But
he's going to slap you.
Yeah, slap box.
He's going to get bait. He doesn't care.
Just do it.
He's going to bait you. Got hit low. I think this might be it.
Solid.
Slappy hands. Man, Beneath, why do you like slapboxing so much?
Slapboxing, Mr. Steal Your
quit
Girl.
Playing.
Mr. Steal Your Girl.
Talon, tell him to quit playing. Quit playing. He's slapboxing.
This character just like slapboxes the hell out of these girls, and then he's just like, Mr. Steal Your Girl, straight up, gone. So we need this one up right now.
Why does he have so much range?
Well, she doesn't have anything close, so it makes sense.
Then, Oki.
Merkava, good block.
No, empty jump. Empty jump, nothing.
I thought he was about to throw a normal. Maybe he was trying to throw a normal really late, but it didn't come out fast enough.
Maybe. And a combo? Wow.
Solid into the corner.
See?
What's the block? It's a throw. There you go.
Mash out that throw.
Another walk-up throw. Third time.
Another one?
No, overhead.
Shake the baby.
Shake the baby. This is the true baby was shaking.
This
is the true baby shaking.
Nope, no punish. Can't punish that.
Solid to the ground. Back into the corner again.
Whip overhead into low.
He doesn't have 100 meter to finish it with
whip some overhead to low again.
Another overhead. And Josh is
whiff overhead to low.
He whiffed the overhead to low. Good cancel in order to keep it. Oh, God, this is not good.
Josh is ready. He left the stick.
Yeah.
He left. It's over.
And that's that. All right, GG.
GG. All right. Next up is apparently. Is that you, Shaka? Man, Venice, how do we good like you?
Just gotta play that chicken.
You gotta show them the card deals,
man. Gotta play that chicken, shake them babies. And when they say stop playing an EX slapbox, you just keep playing.
All right. Okay, so
the man, the legend, Shaka, is sitting in this position over here.
Hashtag Shaka sucks. Thanks,
so, Keenan. So, little known fact, Shaka tried to save Tails.
He did save Tails. What are you talking about?
Oh, he
did. What are you talking about? That happened months ago.
But Tails ain't there. He didn't save anyone.
Yeah, he did. He saved him.
No, not there.
Yeah, he did.
He saved him at the end. First run, though, he didn't save
him. He didn't save him.
Tails fucking died.
EMP. EMP, boom, shakalaka. Fucking... I mean, EMP boom shakalaka save
boom,
tails.
Shakalaka.
Hashtag save tails.
Yeah, he's changed. What are you talking about?
Steel toed loafers. That seems painful.
Yeah, it does, but it's like hide.
Oh, hide.
No hide.
Well, he's playing Lina in what is this? An Ilia color? It's the Ilia color. Yep.
Yeah, it's Ilia.
Yep.
So I expect Koga and Morkuga. And Morkuga.
Button check. This is a button check.
Yeah, I have to.
Yep, they have to
check. They have to go into the game in order to check it, so.
Yeah. It's also definitely because of the controller earlier, so. Alright, so they're starting now. They tapped each other's knuckles, starting the boxing match right now.
Okay.
So they're going into it. Alright, good 2C there. Straight into a solid combo.
Yeah. Oh, he's going for center ball in his corner.
Oh, I expected to Kuga. But maybe it's pretty unsafe at that time.
Oh! EX Kuga! Oh, not EX. My bad.
Shaka's got the grid.
He's doing his reverse as well. He didn't confirm that combo.
Nice assault overhead straight into a more combo.
Misses 2C.
Devin misses 2C. This window's pretty small. Kuga! Jump!
Good reverse beats.
Oh! That guard
Wait,
thrust!
Why'd you do that? Why did you do that? Where's the grid now?
Spend all the meter.
Oh!
He didn't have the grid to make that free. Like,
there's no reason ever to do that if you don't have grid.
Yeah. Well, then again, maybe he really wanted the momentum, but at the same time,
you lose momentum though because you don't have grid.
Plus, Lina wasn't nearly anywhere near death, so I wasn't sure about that. But we'll keep going on to this next match here. Hide with the meter disadvantage. However, he gets the grid now. Make something happen. Oh, the grid break.
Oh, grid roll.
Doesn't finish. DPs.
Random 6B.
Shaka will be getting his grid back in just a moment, but it's okay. Hyde still has grid because Shaka didn't get back in time.
Oh, he got the hand confirmed. Good. 6C.
Solid. What's the mix up?
Block goal, Rekka. Finish it. Come on,
Kuga!
Yes!
There you go.
Don't drop it. You can't drop it.
Yep.
Kuga's hard to do in that situation.
Nah. TKX Kuga.
Okay, if you want to drop your combo, go by me, Chuck.
Nah, you gotta believe.
Nah, don't never believe. I never believe in my combos.
What you gonna do when they come, though? You gotta believe.
I hit confirm. I get 4K. Minimum.
Oh, they're changing characters. That was a mistake. Replay was a mistake.
Okay, so Hyde's not doing well. Hyde doesn't have an overhead other than force function.
There's not really that much you can...
It's Gordo time?
Oh,
Gordo.
No.
It's not,
no,
Gordo,
it's not
time.
Gordo time.
It's Super Hyde. I gotta get green Hyde.
Gotta get green. GGG.
Yo, purple? I didn't know this is purple.
Oh, he's throwing purple drag at people.
Oh, good assault, but it didn't get much from it.
That's a good shield from there because the grid's about to start.
Oh, he
starts. Oh, no, just barely missed the grid opportunity there.
Right up 2B or 2C? I can't tell. I think it's 2B.
If it's long enough, it's probably 2C.
No, it wasn't long though.
Okay. It's pretty safe, actually.
Reverse beats. You think that Shaka was a melting player?
Yeah.
Ah, oh, too late.
Solid to 2C standard combo into the ground. What's the mix up?
Assault jump
run up
C.
Assault jump C.
It's your kill. If he spends
the meter. EX Kuga will probably do it. Chain shift.
If there you go.
To, no, don't need to. All right.
No, if he chain shifted, he will lose the kill.
Chain shift, do another aerial. All right.
Punish with a shield.
Solid damage.
Yeah, send the corner.
Is this going to be another assault overhead?
Kuga.
Nope. Doesn't chance the wake up DP chance.
Oh, wow. Show the shoes.
New shoes. Straight out to the vault. New shoes.
Frickin' new shoes. Oh, he bought the
DO. Straight combo. You got 200 meter here.
He won't kill, but he's gonna take the damage.
He's gonna take all the damage.
He's gonna charge. Get the grid.
Get that.
Hit.
Yep.
It doesn't matter.
Make that
he's
safe.
Still advantage. No, it was an overhead. So he's gonna hit confirm.
Yep. He chain shifted to make that safe.
Why are you force functioning?
Very, very. Force function seems like a good option if you have the grid to do it, because then it's free, correct?
No.
No? If you have chain shift, it. I thought if he had chain shift.
His force function break. Is his only overhead.
Ah, I see.
So he did BC.
I see. Okay. Then what am I thinking about?
You're thinking about guard cancel.
Yeah, I'm thinking about the guard cancel, right? Okay.
All right. Kuga. Next on stream, and also Manabe's probably dead.
Kuga, aka throw crescent moons, Frito Lays.
Kuga's great.
Croissants.
Kuga's love. Kuga's life.
When in doubt, Kuga.
It's always. Okay, hold on.
Talent on the mic here.
Fuck right. Kuga.
All right, Brett thinks I'm doing a shitty job, so he's tagging in. It's true.
Are you playing dodgeball?
Is this dodgeball?
They're playing dodgeball over there. Anyways,
yeah,
hey Brad.
With how you doing?
It's all right.
I just woke up, so.
Wait, when did you have to go to sleep?
I took a nap on that couch because I only had an hour of sleep today, so that's why I'm not entered in this tournament.
Fair enough.
So I'll just be on mic instead.
How's Seth going?
It's going good. Yeah. Right. Yeah. He's Well, he's, there's some new stuff people have been coming out with and stuff as the game's been coming out, so.
That's good.
I'm not sure if it outraces the effectiveness of other people learning about him, but there's some fight back. It's not entirely lost.
As long as you have something, at least.
Yeah. I definitely feel like the way I describe him is, he's a character with gimmicks, and you try and confuse your opponent to turn those gimmicks into legitimate mix-ups.
So Yosuke in the original?
No, Yosuke has, like, real pressure game, though. His 5B is +1 on block.
And, oh, yeah, that's true. I forgot about that.
But, I mean, kind of, yeah. It's a different game, though, hard to say.
Fair enough. Anyway, so it's Sudden Blackout versus 2GIG.
Oh, okay. Who does Blackout play?
He used to play Batista, but now he plays Waldstein.
That should be fun. We don't have we don't actually have. Well, you're supposed to show us the fruits of your labor. That top level Yuzu. Yo, my Yuzu and my Hilda are fucking godlike. I just like too tired today. But next tournament I will.
You can't show off anything if you can't do anything.
Well, I was gonna turn into this. I was gonna sign up. Then I heard it was $5, and that was too tired. And I was like, okay, no.
Yeah, it's not worth it.
I was gonna coach Yuji because Yuji plays Seth too, so I was just gonna go in as coach and just tell him how to win. But he didn't enter either. So, but what's this thing? Yeah, we don't have that many Wald players in NorCal. So,
really?
Yeah. So
function. Not all
Doesn't
of his
Mike muscles do?
He does, but he doesn't like come out that much. I mean, he's not here today. And he doesn't show up to many Game Center casuals. So.
Okay.
So I'm not sure how much experience T-Gang has against Wald. He's a very annoying character.
Like that, long.
Yeah.
Long ranging.
I mean, he actually subs Wald, so he knows, like, you know, the basics about the character. But. All
right. That's Blackout, though. That's a real question.
Yeah.
Because Carbine.
Yeah, that's the thing.
Stuff
is,
like that.
Blackout might just die here. It could just already be over. But let's. Oh!
Does he need one more hit? Yes.
Yeah. But next hit will kill for sure. Yeah, that's it.
That's it.
Oh,
never mind, but 6B.
Yeah. 6B.
Just throw your blood out.
Oh, that's good. I like that a lot.
Whip jumps 6C and
yeah,
2 over.
Quite legit.
Yeah. Deck it.
Oh, that's actually a really good trade. Yeah. Oh!
Oh my! That hitbox 6. Oh, what is he doing? I thought he was just gonna go for 4B in the corner.
Yeah, I don't know. Some weird scramble there, but 2 gig now with Vorpal, 200 meter.
Losing health as
I think he's gonna look for a trap. It might be over here. He actually has a 6,000 damage combo.
Oh, and he has 200 meter. Yes.
Yeah, no, he's actually just like dead, I think.
Yeah,
he's dead. Oh no! Yeah.
EX girl? There you go! 2-3,
yeah. Yeah, 2 gig was definitely fishing for that trap. He has a 6.6k damage combo from Trap Start. So
I found that yesterday actually.
Oh, you got to fight against that? It's not fun.
It's not fun. But I played Batista, so she's not fun either.
Oh yeah. Okay, so I mean, this is actually kind of interesting because he can 360 in these weird gaps, so it's a little more weird. Yeah,
yeah.
Like that's actually, you know, very annoying to deal with as Carmine. Now he's gonna get Vorpal here, very close. Blackout gets it just by a smidgen.
He's still on advantage though.
Sets a trap.
Spends all the meter.
Okay.
Gains a little bit live.
Yeah, bring him to the corner. That was kind of awkward, but.
Ooh. That could have gone either way.
Yeah.
Carmine trap is a hold button, right?
What? Yeah, you hold down the button, you release A or B.
Okay.
Yeah, he actually probably could have just backdashed from that blockout. Like.
That all depends on do you know what Carmine's doing?
Yeah. Oh!
Oh, wall hitbox, please. Box the overhead, box the overhead.
Oh, okay.
Shield it.
I'm surprised he pressed a button after shooting rather than trying to throw or something.
Yeah.
Considering how slow his normals are.
Okay. He was close enough to do a 368.
Yeah, definitely.
Oh, good tech.
Oh, very nice.
On the ground.
That was a very fast tech. Oh, good back dash.
Good back.
2 gig unable to convert that. Oh, tries to go for the jump, so he gets it. Yeah. Okay.
Wall slam.
Is it Oki?
Oh,
yeah.
Just micro dash. Well, not even micro dash because that's his dash. Why? Why is his dash slower than his run?
Because. Whoa. Oh, it's so close actually.
Rare meter's gonna go to Blackout.
Oh.
He tried grabbing.
Yeah. 2 gigabyte relying very heavily so far to Salt Jump C to try and open up Blackout.
Good back dash. Avoids the king grab.
I don't think I've seen him do a single held C. Oh, I spoke too soon. Gets mashed out of it immediately, actually. Really good butt pressing there by Blackout.
No tech. Okay, what combo is going to go for?
Oki? Oh, no. Corey carry.
Air tech?
Oh!
Ooh, that was great. Couple more.
Alright, 2 gigs still in the corner. Text the gold throw. Alright, he has. He might. Oh, yeah. It could just actually be.
He might kill him?
No. But he has so many. Yeah, next is dead. Oh, it's over.
It's over.
Yeah, he has so much mana. As long as he just drop this, he's dead. Yeah.
You didn't even need to do
the
full
then
combo.
You do the super cool and you fucking do
and then
like a billion
supers.
Yeah.
Super. Yeah, that thing hurts.
Yeah, but that was actually pretty close. Blackout was some good stuff there.
Both of those characters I fear fighting, but at least one of them I can zone out.
Yeah, yeah. I don't really like fighting against Carmine either, the characters. Actually, the way I describe him, even though he's not like considered top, I think the most obnoxious thing about him is in order to actually fight him properly, you as the opposing player have to actually do a ridiculous amount of homework. And that's actually something that not many other characters have to do. But you kind of need to go and really deeply understand Carmine, I feel like, to know what's going on.
Because otherwise, he's just going to make you block
yeah.
forever.
Like, with some other characters, you don't actually need to know exactly what's going on. Just some pieces, like, oh, you know, minus here. But, like, because of just the way Carmine works, like, if you don't know anything about any particular facet, he can, like, abuse it and be greedier, you know. Mm. So that's the one thing about that character that's pretty annoying. He's like, you pretty much forces the opponent to do all their homework. Otherwise,
yeah, they actually study it.
Otherwise, it's quite annoying to deal with. But anyways, coming up, we have a... Oh, this should be a really good match here. We have Tari versus Vineeth. Tari is a really, really solid Yuzu player. And Vineeth is Vineeth.
Vineeth. Random we're buying colors, apparently.
Four leaves. It's equipped. Vineeth already got his color earlier.
Yeah, it's always important to have your color.
So I actually don't know how this matchup goes. But,
Merkava could grab her because of Merkava.
Yeah. But Yuzu has teleports, so my assumption is it's another one of the matchups where it's actually all about teleporting, which... The more I watch and study Yuzu stuff, the more matchups feel that way, where it's actually, like, to the point where I'm like, wait, why am I playing Seth? Why don't I just play Yuzu? She teleports better than Seth does. But, so Yuzu gets a nice misfinder hit, goes into BB, drops a dash B ender, but Vineeth pressing buttons after the flip. Another flip. That's plus. Gets hit by 2C here.
Last hit of 2C.
So, elbow. Interesting choice there. Oh, maybe trying to bait out super or something? Because technically you can actually elbow if you time it. You can technically beat Merkava's EX hand slap with elbow.
But Vineeth didn't have meter at the time.
Oh, then yeah, actually, I have no idea. You're right. No. You need a meter. Oh, there it is. Wow.
Okay, I have to leave, so okay. I'll leave it to you.
Ooh. So Yuzuha with Vorpal. About to lose it though. Vineeth looking like he's getting Vorpal here. Will it matter though? Oh, and the guard break. So Vineeth about to turn this match over. But WoW gets hit by Wake Up 2A. That's going to be it.
Yeah, Tari takes that round. First match, right?
Yeah, I actually don't know how often they play each other, because...
I'm assuming not too often?
Yeah, because Vineeth doesn't show up here that often. Yeah. Because it looks like... It actually looks like Vineeth doesn't know what's going on yet. And I'm actually not sure if Arthur has a plan either. But, he's just kind of flipping at Vineeth.
Well, if he's doing Tiger Knee Flip, it's like buzz. So
yeah,
okay.
No.
But if he's doing Ground Flip, then it's like, I guess Vineeth's probably inexperienced in the matchup, though. This one of the matchups I do like is Yuzu, though. I feel it's, like, even. Pretty even.
Yeah, well, you know, you can deal with... You can deal with his range
Hold
decently
on.
With teleport.
After this match.
When you're done, grab this guy in the red shirt and I'll let him pause.
All right, so match two underway here.
All right. Oh, interesting there.
Oh, nice.
Nice confirm.
Doesn't block the second hit of 2C.
All right. Oh, that's at least sick. He doesn't press buttons there. Oh.
Nice. Should lead to 4B knockdown. Oh, bait to throw tag.
All right. Yeah, that's plus for some dumb
reason. Nice 4C.
Good 4C call out there by Tari, by the way. Dash B.
Knockdown. Shield the last hit. Oh, no. It's pretty hard to throw. I guess I don't win.
This should be it.
Yeah, that's it. Good shit.
Yeah, they need... Oh, wow.
Teleports. Very nice. Knockdown.
Dash.
Nice throw. Quarter knockdown. Plus... Very nice pressure.
Wow.
I guess you want to change shift there.
Oh, or change shift.
Oh no, he no longer has Ripple.
Whoa.
Yeah, that's the fun stuff. Oh, doesn't confirm. Things not looking too well now. Ripple is now in Tari's favor.
Yeah, Tari's sitting on 200 meter. He's going to go ahead and teleport. Oh, good nice throw. Tech. Wow, Greasy's oh, wow. Over that 2C. And Beneath,
oh no, he drops it.
He can, oh no, it looks like it's gonna go to Yuzu.
Yeah.
So Tari, yeah, nice again, teleport. Using teleports, yes. Lands at 5A, but doesn't combo off of it.
Yeah. Nice pressure.
All right, Beneath blocks that stagger.
Doesn't confirm.
Oh. With actually 10 seconds on the clock, Beneath, he can just land a single hit here. Oh, tries to bait the throw tech. Really good there by Vinny, but throw teching is.
I think. Oh, it's Vinny's round. Wow.
Yeah. I think the reason why he didn't throw tech there is I think he thought he had the life lead.
Yeah. I did too. The health values look pretty similar, but I guess the fireball tipped
over. Oh, I forget, did he string in the hands at the end there? Because that probably just tipped if he did.
Oh, no, he threw a fireball.
Oh, he threw a fireball.
Oh, yeah. Nice. Mashes out all 8 hits. That is plus by far correctly. Nice. Corner combo. Knockdown. Oh, no, he drops
right,
it.
Veil off.
Oh,
no.
We found the gap. Nice. Beneath takes that match. 1-1.
Alright, so Vinny adjusting?
Yeah. He adjusted pretty well towards the end there. Things were looking pretty hopeless that first round, though.
Yeah. Really good turnaround there by Vinny.
Yeah, definitely. Okay, last match of the set.
After this. Yeah, it's almost over.
Nice slash, confirm. Huh? Oh no! Drop. Nice. Okay. Nice. Shin in a knockdown. Nice. Wow. Anti-airs with 2B. Catches him. Nice throw. Oh no, he doesn't match up the rest of the hits. Throw tag. Okay, corner combo. Knockdown. What's the Oki? Nice fell off. Nice teleport. Ooh, very nice.
Alright.
Flip.
Nice throw, tech.
Now it's Beneath's turn.
Yeah.
He started off in A, so it's probably too pro-rated for... Never mind.
Wow.
Nice. Wake up 5C. Alright, sorry on match point.
Oh, nice. And the confirm? Oh,
no. Missed time to flip.
Yeah. Alright, he gets this, though.
Good. End in air tech.
Oh.
He's in the corner. Not really a nice place to be. He just runs up
and throws
this
back.
Okay.
Tari good 5A by Tari. Super?
Yeah.
Super again? Yeah.
What's the Oki here? Oh, he blocks the low.
Oh,
very
my
nice.
God.
Oh, no, he drops the pickup.
Okay, back full screen here.
I think Atari just... Oh, no!
Oh, no,
Atari may end up losing... If he loses this round, it will be because he's being too passive. Like,
yes, oh yeah. My God!
Yeah, he's dead.
Extremely too passive towards
him. Definitely, Atari trying to play too safe at the end there. I think he just really wanted to get distance and teleport into a flip and then just you know, stagger him to death. But yeah, just like two clumsy mistakes letting Vineet get in there and get hit.
Oh no. He gets the throw bait successfully, but
yeah,
doesn't punish
it. Wow. Vineet so on top of these supers right now in this game.
Yeah, he's pretty on point with him. Okay. So Atari. Back with Vorpal.
Oh, this is really big because now Atari's going to probably get his next Vorpal. Yes. What?
Oh my gosh. He jumped in and chain shifted. I'm not sure what
he
was
I think he wanted
for.
An assault, but he probably maybe mashed D too many times or something like that.
That is true.
Oh,
oh no,
no,
he jumps.
Oh, is this over?
No.
Oh. Oh, it was a counter hit.
Yeah, I don't believe
it. Oh,
it's
so.
Over.
Oh,
now,
it's
over. Very
wow.
Nice. Unfortunate. But Atari takes that match. No, Vineet takes that match. Oh well.
Wow.
Reptari. It's okay, he's in losers. Still has a chance. And now I'm up for Aquapaza.
Atari like kind of wanted like that last match.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. No, no, no. You know what it was? Was the critical point was I said it on stream too, but like not the final round, but the second to last round where you tied it up 1-1.
Yeah.
Where he had a huge life lead, but he like backed off and he was like too scared to go in and he like ran in and then you just hit him like twice.
Yeah.
I think that was really the big point where
the thing like there was like most players like when they're like one hit away, like on a bar, like just like mashing, they like tend to lean for it. So like I like that dive kick. Like after that, I was kind of screwed because I was minus and I wouldn't have gotten enough pressure to like gotten a mix up, and he probably would have got away.
Yeah.
So I was just like, this really has to work.
Yeah.
So I like waited in his face and then I did the dive kick.
Yeah.
But yeah, like I kind of robbed him a little bit there.
A little bit.
What's up?
It's pretty fast. I want to say it's like 8 or 9. The dive kick itself.
If it's 8, then it would be like 12 after one startup.
Something like that, yeah.
You had some good throws, though.
Yeah, also towards the end, like,
You supered.
Yeah, I was supering, and you were like, do you want to, like, the final mix up? Like, and you want to, like, just, like, mix me up and, like, finish me off?
Yeah, I want to do
more. Yeah. A lot of players, like, when they're, like, one hit away, they just kind of want to, like, wrap it up as opposed to, like, you know, just, like, playing it safe.
Yeah.
Like, Clark. I think Clark's going to be on the dry list.
So, what is this in the tournament here? Is this winners or losers we're about to watch?
This is losers.
Okay.
Earlier, this Lin player beat Dasabro.
Oh, CT Warrior? Yeah.
Yep.
Who beat Zero Hour?
Actually, I don't know.
Yo, Zero Hour, who put you in losers?
Me? Oh, yeah, Atari did.
Oh, this Atari, yeah, okay, yeah.
Yeah,
well,
yeah.
You play Akatsuki, right? The matchup does not look fun at all.
I don't know how like, you'd even get in.
The matchup, I don't actually know how you get in that. Because like, she can switch sides, she's cheap.
Yeah.
You can't even like slowly corner her.
I don't know.
It doesn't change anything.
Yeah, so I really like Zero Hour. Like, even though I was playing like a pretty, like kind of considered very weak character, probably the worst.
Yeah,
I think Chaos is worse than him.
I really like hyping up Zero Hour. I think he's really legit. I think if he just like focuses his game more, he can like place really high.
Yeah, absolutely, he has a lot of potential. Like, even not just in this game. Like, I've seen him play in Blaze Blue. He has very solid defense. Very, very good fundamentals.
Well, I asked what his main game is. He goes BB and Unio.
Huh?
I asked him what his main game is, and he goes BB and Unio. So I asked him what he played in the past. He said KOL.
Oh, okay.
So all
right, cool.
I think he's trying to focus on like. Yeah.
Wow. Okay, that was a very good parry there. I believe after parry, like. You negate all the blocks or something?
Oh, it's you get an auto follow up.
Oh, okay. So
it looks unless it's different than in Blitz, but I don't think it is. So it looks like it just
Kuga, like she kind of recovers pretty quickly from it, so she probably couldn't have gotten much there. All right, Zero Hour getting some. All right, bounces combo.
That dive is so good, by the way. Zero Hour is really good.
Nice.
Really nice change up there.
Alright, gets the fireball out.
Oh,
nice. Oh, alright, gets him with the classic. I don't know if he knows about the overhead at the end.
Not very many people know that much about Kotsky.
Yeah.
Considering, you know, they're pretty rare. Gets an overhead hit. You get Kuga? Oh, no. Okay. He's gonna go.
Interesting.
Roll.
I guess he baits the DP there. Nice. Throws again. Oh wow, this is interesting. He's like countering, because like normally ground Kuga into dash is minus, but since he's doing the fireball, he's going through it and then probably being like plus there. Alright, that's a mix up here.
Oh, nice DP.
Ooh, very good.
Oh, that's juicy.
Yeah, right there. He like air teched and thought he could like hit some buttons, but Zero was in his face already meeting him.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah, I think the green shields are that. It's kind of weird.
Nice. Yeah.
All right, that's a good combo here. Ooh. Okay, not bad.
Is he getting a hit by
that? Wow. Yeah. You kind of have to bait stuff when people bail off, like, you know,
well,
like that.
Yeah. Well, Lin's fucking IW is insane.
Yeah, yeah. Also, it's safe on block
if you don't. If the whole thing goes off.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I think you have to interrupt it in between.
Yeah, there's a small gap.
Yeah. Defense by Zero over here. Nice.
Oh,
he didn't believe in the hit there. Yeah.
That was a good hit though.
Yeah, no, that was definitely the point in the string where it was negative.
Oh,
wow.
Three. Oh, shit. That almost killed him.
Zero staying very calm here.
Oh, okay. Not sure if he knows much about Lin. He's being very respectful.
Yeah, yeah, he's kind of. He's respecting, like, strings that he shouldn't have.
Yeah.
There was one good point. Like, he got that, like, dash B, I think.
Yeah, yeah.
If he finished that combo, he probably would have had that game. So, 1-0 CT hour, or CT warrior.
Yeah, CT warrior is actually a super old school player.
Okay. Where's he from?
Melty.
Like, what part? Where's he from?
Somewhere in NorCal.
Oh, NorCal? Oh, yeah. Wow, I've never seen him before.
He's Netplay warrior.
Ah, I see. That's cool. Yeah, he was doing some work earlier. Beat Dasa, bro.
Nice. Confirmed here by Zero.
Yeah, try to hit buttons after the fireball. I'm pretty sure that's plus on hit.
Yeah, Zero is really good spacing his fireball and then, you know, doing that dash B.
Yeah. He's kind of just trying to stay out of the Kuga range just like that.
Yeah.
It's interesting though, like he keeps like challenging, like he keeps colliding with the fireball with his own fireball.
Yeah.
So is that dive down like?
It's really hard to come in.
I see. Is it? It's not plus or anything.
It's
right?
No, it's not plus, but it's safe on block.
Okay.
It seems like the way you need to deal with it, if you think it's gonna do, is you have to air shield it.
Air shield. Interesting. Yeah. Oh, nice DP by Zero. Oh, getting into it. Get hype on that read. Maybe get ride this momentum.
I feel like this match really has to do with how the players are figuring out this matchup. Because I feel like for a lot of the closer range characters against Akatsuki, Akatsuki actually can do pretty well in the close range games. I feel like a lot of players may need to adjust and play more of a lane game.
Yeah, absolutely.
And if they're not comfortable with that, if they just continue to go in, then it's actually, you know, a lot better for Akatsuki.
Yeah, I don't think he has like slow normals.
Oh, his normals are really good. Okay, his 5B is like 7 frames.
Oh, that's good. Okay.
I think it's.
Yeah, he has a DP. He has.
Oh, wow. He has a DP that can't get its input reversed. I think his 2A or his 5A is like only minus 1, I think. Okay. So, I mean, his
little like, little punches.
Yeah, so, I mean, his normals are really good, actually. I mean, which makes sense. He's a tiny, cool character. He's gonna have to have them. But, and, you know, this stuff here is pretty good.
Nice baiting. Baiting the escape.
Oh. Yeah. Oh, wow!
Oh, very nice counter,
Like, that's really good. CT Warrior may not be.
Ooh, good bait! He did it earlier. Yeah. Not gonna work again.
Yeah, honestly.
Come on, he did it last time.
I think it's not a very good idea to bail off of Kotsky.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Okay, throws it again.
CT Warrior's gonna adapt to that. He's already done that, like, the last four chain shifts.
Yeah, I think you actually have to just be really lame in this matchup. I mean.
See, like, what. It's weird, like, Zero is, like, kind of playing it lame.
Yeah. No, entirely. He's just gonna. Yeah. He slowly gets in.
What do you think?
He pushes
like,
button, fireball. And
yeah, yeah.
And then puts him in the corner and waits.
Yeah, I feel like he might. CJ Warrior might be going in a little bit too hard.
Oh yeah, I mean CJ Warrior is pretty aggressive. Honestly, I think that's close to people's consensus. He presses a lot of buttons, does things like that. I mean, it's Lin, so.
It's a little thing that follows Lin around.
It's a dragon.
Okay.
Oh, that sucks!
Oh, Destiny.
He didn't know the jump parts are there. Oh, yeah, back there.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Ooh. Ooh, this looks so cool.
This character's so manly.
Yeah,
oh.
He's pretty manly.
Yeah, chain shift.
Oh!
So we're in there.
He has 0 hour. I think CG Warrior kind of figuring out that he actually has to respect this character in close range. Because I don't actually think that a brawl is actually in Lin's favor. Or at least, you know, it's even enough. That,
yeah, he has a life lead, but like he's like dashing in and throwing and like doing stuff like that. He really doesn't need to. He can kind of just like stay at his like Kuga range and like go in only when
it's
safe.
See, like this stuff is actually not good because, you know.
Yeah, ground Kuga into dash is minus.
You don't. It's pretty gimmicky, but I mean, he's doing good right now, but he's moving forward like this. It's actually kind of.
Yeah,
with one hit here, 0 hour, that's not punishable.
Okay. Yeah.
That's good though. Yeah.
Interesting. I thought.
And that's.
But that was definitely minus.
Oh, it is.
Yeah. I guess just, he just didn't catch.
It's just a gimmick.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
It's a solid gimmick.
Wow. 200 meter both. Last round, last game.
Yeah.
Oh, punish.
Nice. Going to get a good corner carry. He actually called that up back, but he missed time it just by a bit. Oh, I don't know why he doesn't do the under. Maybe likes a closer knockdown or something. I don't know.
Yeah, not sure. Okay, here we go.
Alright,
might have just missed the button the last time. I'm not sure.
Nice. I'm blocking.
Okay.
Alright, he's making just waste all his meter.
Ooh! This is looking really good for CT Warrior here. But 0 hour has chain chip. Oh my god!
Oh, good tech!
Yeah, good tech.
No,
that's it. Yeah. That was such an unfortunate hit for 0 hour because he had Vorpal. And if he actually hit CT Warrior again, he was going to knock the grid in his favor.
Right.
Because he was only down by like a half a grid.
Yeah, exactly. Also,
it was like 2 to 1.5.
After he teched that throw, I guess there was like some sort of meta there. Like, he didn't go in. He kind of like baited
him. He was waiting for Getsu, probably, the DP.
Yeah, that's probably. What he was doing. Yeah. I don't remember him doing that though. Like that was like there was only 2 throw techs that match.
I think he's just being
patient. Yeah, he's just baiting him. Yeah. He did present DP as an option.
Getting your
a lot that
tech
match.
Thrown and then doing a super is pretty.
Yeah, it's like the classic.
Yeah, it's the classic.
It's like, oh, +8. Thanks. That just means like a TPU, huh?
Yeah.
Alright, we got Pain. Playing Batista.
I'm gonna check
Sam.
The bracket. I might actually go get food, so I may be back.
Hey, Sam. Yeah, Merkava's pretty scummy. What's up, guys? Doing this commentary for this anime game. You get a haircut. Nah. I don't know where this is in the bracket. Oh, that's strange. Hold on. 1 second, guys. Okay. All right, you want to commentate, Tari?
Hello.
You don't seem to get very salty. You seem to have a very good attitude about things.
I enjoy playing the game.
If I lost the way that you did, I'd probably like punch a wall or something.
Oh, no. I mean, it's my fault. Whatever. I had fun.
No, that's a good attitude to have. A lot of people, like, Sam kind of get salty. Like, you know, it's hard to, like, I always quote this from Daigo, but he said the hardest thing about a fighting game is to lose without making excuses.
Oh.
To walk away from a match without saying anything.
Oh, yeah, I mean, like.
It really is.
I mean, like, There are times where, you know, you're like, oh no, you know, like, that's not what I wanted, you know, I lost
because
of that.
Yeah, you'll be frustrated, but like,
but I mean, in the end,
yeah, I know, that's why, like, I definitely respect players that, like, when they lose in, like, some stupid way, they don't, like, like, whine, complain, like, punch.
It makes you want to...
I get frustrated.
Oh, it makes you want to, like, rematch, that's it.
Yeah, exactly.
Also, this match is really silly.
Oh my god, I thought he'd be playing Batista.
No, apparently Payne is just going all in on Hilda.
Okay, that's cool.
And I mean, it's working.
Yeah, I guess so. I mean, like, I understand, like, in any fighting game, people hate the mirrors. So,
yeah,
like,
no,
you always see the sub played when, like, the other guy, like,
oh, yeah, when
rather
the mirror
not
comes
play the
up?
Mirror. Yeah. And in, like, Payne's case, I assume he played the T, so...
AJ, are you going with AJ?
Yeah,
he's already got my
pressure
order.
Here. Oh, I don't know who this is. Is this Sam?
This is Sam getting hits.
Okay,
getting his hits in. There you go.
Okay, Sam's in.
Yeah,
right
Sam
now.
Sam really likes ending his combos with force function.
Yeah,
I'm not sure. I'm not really sure what he gets from it. It's some sort of air tech.
Yeah, no. What he does is he likes to do a force function into the rain, like that thing, but
yeah.
It's like coming outwards.
Oh, he wants them next to him?
Yeah, so like when you air tech, you think you can like punish them because like you're air teching or whatever, but then the rain like comes from behind
you. I see.
You.
I don't know.
It's
I feel like...
I don't really like it, but like...
I feel like it's a waste of his grid. Because like
oh,
he doesn't
yeah,
really...
it does cost. I forgot about that.
Yeah, he also doesn't actually get a knockdown, right?
So, yeah, exactly. Like... I don't know. Maybe it's... I mean, some people like to do weird knockdowns just like for knockdown variety.
That's true.
Yeah, I feel like that's the reason. I'm not sure why. I could probably ask him later. Yes, the little the spike from the ground is very minus from Hilda. Usually, a time to go in versus Hilda is like after you've blocked the little
oh,
ground
the,
spike.
Oh, the low. The ground
yeah,
spike
the
is minus 7. Yeah,
minus
pretty
seven,
bad.
That's kind of when you go in.
Yeah, it's literally when she does that, she pretty much loses pressure.
Right, right. But that's kind of like the thing to keep you in check, you know?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, so if you wait for it, like, you'll definitely get rewarded.
Her front spike is also minus 7.
Yeah. Nice block. Oh, I blocked this.
Yeah, this looks really funny because they're just...
Yeah. Oh, he shielded that. I thought he would have mashed there.
I think it was too low.
I see.
Probably still plus.
Ooh,
oh, that was a nice throw attack.
Nice. Linchpin whiffs. I guess you can only really do linchpin mix-up like when they're in the middle of it. Huh. Maybe if you like green shielded it, you can get out of the range of the linchpin.
There's actually... So it's sort of interesting, actually. The way the... Oh, you mean the linchpin?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you were talking about the low for a second. Yeah, no, the linchpin... It's weird.
Yeah.
They're actually, after certain things, if she linchpins, you can just assault and you'll get past the linchpin or
see.
Run forward. After
right.
Only after certain things, of course.
Yeah.
It also depends on how big she makes the linchpin.
Yeah, huh, that's true. So many things. Like, I fight Sam a good amount, but there's still so many things I don't understand about his character.
No, I definitely agree. Hilda is, like, very strange character
yeah.
to play against.
Well, it's raining. Raining black things. Oh my god, this is very close. Oh my god. Will he go low? Will he go low? Will he go low? Oh, he
oh.
went high!
Payne shaking his head.
Oh, what did he
oh.
kill him? Oh my god.
Oh,
that is,
oh, what
is, oh man.
That was
actually,
confusing.
Wait, who put Payne and losers? 2K? Oh,
yeah.
We're in there.
Oh, I see.
Wait,
oh, I see. So he was saying like he already used his he already used the pin
yeah.
at the beginning of the combo.
Oh,
so
you
the first time you hit them with pin, it stands them. The uh-huh. second time you hit them with pin, they ground tech. So he couldn't do pin into the 5C
yeah,
super
yeah, yeah.
ender.
So he had no choice there.
Yeah.
So he just kind of returned to
so he did, he just did his thing.
Yeah. That's fine. Okay, yeah. This is what I kind of expected from the beginning.
I like this purple Batista color.
It's pretty kawaii.
Please,
kawaii as fuck. Dude, I saw this stupid shirt that Lord Knight posted. It was like people just mad that I'm kawaii as fuck or something. It was
really?
It was really
that
bad.
Sounds like an SKD shirt.
Yeah.
Doesn't it?
Yeah, I know, right? That's something you would wear. Well, you have to be a certain kind of person to wear that shirt. I definitely wouldn't be friends with
oh,
you.
Oh, dude,
if you that
is
shirt.
Such a...
Oh, man, I hate that shirt.
I really hate that mix-up.
It's
anything,
so, like...
Anything into the CS V-drill is so Ming.
Yeah. The thing is, like, it's so, like, when you get chain shift, you just, it's almost like guaranteed. It's like you just do dash C, chain shift, and then you either do
yeah,
that,
just
or,
do that
the,
yeah.
Or
a
delay 2C.
Yeah.
For low. But the thing is, with that mix-up, well, it kind of sucks for us, because we don't have, like, a DP.
Yeah.
So, like, we kind of just have to guess. But,
well, I mean, like,
most
even characters
like,
with DPs, if she just CS's and blocks, because, you know.
Yeah. Though she does choose to like do the mix-up, it's not like that. Oh shit!
That was funny as heck. I don't know if you saw it. The dash C, it just stopped concentrate.
Yeah, yeah.
That was good.
Alright, does block the next up. Oh, goes low. He didn't
block that low. Oh, he gets the cross up.
Oh, and he goes
overhead. Oh, he gets the reset. This could be it, actually. I think he can combo this into EX, yeah. EX flash kick.
That always looks funny. It's just
the
2A super.
2A flash kick, yeah.
2A super. Doesn't even look like it should combo.
But it's a 3-frame super, so.
Yeah.
Ridiculously fast.
Yeah, she's one of the few, like her and like I think another character.
Oh, nice
block. I can't save Chump.
So one of the other places you can get in against Hilda, you know that back spike?
Yeah.
It has like 28 frames of startup or something.
Yeah, yeah. So if you know he's doing like the charge up back spike, you can like go in and hit him.
Yeah. If you're really good about it, you can actually react to the startup and jump forward.
Oh. And it'll whiff?
And you can if you do jump forward, assault, air assault, it actually whiffs under you.
Wow, I didn't know that.
But it's really hard to react fast enough.
Yeah.
Like you have to react pretty much early as possible. I think you have to get it on like frame 14 or 15 or something. It's like impossible.
Yeah. Usually when I block Hilda, I kind of just like wait for the mix-up like to end. Because there is a point where
it always ends.
It always ends.
I mean, the only thing she can do to reset it is the back spike, which is...
Yeah, exactly. But it's like after that, the mix-up has to happen.
Yeah.
You kind of just have to wait.
If she keeps trying to back spike you, well,
that's... Oh, what?
Oh, oh man, wow.
That was so janky.
That was janky, but that was scary as heck, actually.
I guess it's like he baited something, and then he's like,
oh,
wait.
Oh, good bail-off. That was a very good
bail-off. Oh, he did super. Why did he super?
Oh, what the?
I was really surprised. I thought, okay.
Okay, he has a chance here.
Yeah, that's what I thought he would do.
No.
Oh, no, he jumped!
That's it.
Yeah. He jumped. That's air unblockable.
Yeah. I was going to say he's just waiting for Batista to jump.
Exactly, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh!
Batista's whiff throw is so great.
Yeah.
Oh, good flash kick.
Sam, like, Pain's Demon in this game? Like,
what?
Is Sam, like, Pain's Demon in this game?
I have no idea.
Okay. As he jumps, he's over him. Never mind.
Because like, that setup, I don't know if you saw that. That's so mean. You put the crystal off screen.
Yeah.
And then when you pop it, it pushes them out of the corner.
Oh, that's kind of cool. Mashes out. Oh, there's a lunch pin.
Good luck. That's minus 7.
Oh, shit.
Okay, he gets that throw break.
Oh, I thought he would answer that. It looked like he was looking for it. Oh, he does the overhead.
This is going to do...
Yeah, it's
going
to kill him. Two-way super, yeah.
CS? Oh, okay. I didn't know if he had to CS that or not. I think he could have CS'd it for one more hit anyway.
Yeah, Sam had that, honestly. He had this one combo. I'm not really sure. Maybe he didn't drop it. Like, it's not a whole lot.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, but it looked like he dropped it.
So... Actually, what I thought was going to happen there was Pain had a lot of Vorpal.
Yeah.
So I thought what was going to happen was he was going to CS in the middle of his combo and combo into Infinite Worth for the guaranteed kill.
Yeah, that would have been good. I enter?
Wait, no, you were. If you don't want to enter, I think you can just opt out.
Yeah, I'm good. I was going to enter Blaze Blue if SG came. I wanted to beat him.
Oh.
I wanted to beat him real bad. Hey, if you're watching this, Derek, I'm going to get you next time.
Beneath has it out for you, Derek.
Yeah, he beat me at Evo, but it was a good match. Ooh, jumps over
that
again.
Was nice.
Sam really has to like control his emotions here, though. He generally gets very frustrated.
So this setup, people complain about that setup. It's a very strong setup. Pain actually isn't dashing. You're supposed to dash 5A every single time.
Right.
But shielding it and pushing her back and then guessing when she has to dash is your only option if you don't have a DD.
Yeah.
Or a counter. Counters make that a completely fake setup.
Right.
Oh, Sam.
Sam's got to focus here. I really think, like, it's...
Oh.
Oh, God.
I got the drunk guy on my back.
Good match there. Nice. Here's him. Somebody get Clark out of here.
I think he's getting more drunk.
What are you doing? Run! Stop!
Don't give him anything else to drink. Don't give him
anything.
Don't give
him more.
All right. Good job. Okay. Good block.
Oh, nice. Actually, right. Very good.
Sam is doing a really good job this round.
Yeah, he stayed calm there. Nice.
Oh,
this
he got the low. Yeah.
Really
that low is so mean.
Oh, he wicked mashed.
That was just 2A. That wasn't even a low.
Yeah. It looked like he dropped the... What was that? Oh, it was probably a...
Falling meaty orb hit. Oh my god.
This is my wicked
back up. Super super. He might do the big super. I think he's gonna do it if he comes close.
Oh shit.
I told you I do it.
Yeah, you were right. You called it.
Oh, this is so anime.
He got this. All right, going into the last round.
Yeah, Sam's gonna have a lot of momentum going into this match, though.
But Payne has 200 meter.
That is true. So he might super at the start. Okay, he doesn't. Nice, oh, anti-air! He finally anti-aired him after all those jumps. Oh, he drops his goal!
He just does it again.
Yeah, but he did shield that jump in, though. But I guess it doesn't matter.
No, Batista's jump in, if you shield it at the lowest possible height, it makes her have a gap if she pushes the button.
Okay.
Oh, she's like not even actually like minus.
I see.
But it does mess up. So what happens is a lot of players, they push the button as early as possible.
Yeah.
It just messes up their time for the bottom push.
Oh god, I thought he would have answered there. Oh, overhead. Oh, no, I did it.
Oh. Oh my god.
Sam's gonna stay calm here.
All right, he's blocking. Oh, that was a good match. Oh no, that's it. That's game.
No, what? He dropped it.
Oh, Payne drops. That was a close set. That was a really close set.
That was
set.
A really good match. Dang. Sam, okay, see, Sam, like, saved that anti-air. Like, he had an anti-air at him for a while, and he finally got it. Like, those are the points in, like, in fighting games where you haven't, like, shown an option in a while.
And then you pull it out.
You pull it out, you have to, like, you gotta, like, it's gotta pay.
It has
much.
To hit, yeah.
It has to pay.
You have to
the combo. But he dropped it, so that sucks.
Yeah, that was very unfortunate. He had a really good shot with that.
Yeah, exactly. Like, right. When he got that, I'm like, wow, he did it.
All right, so apparently I have to play again because I'm
good
losers.
Luck, Tari.
Because of you.
Yeah.
All right.
What? Really? You should. Dang, that was really close. Yeah. Yeah, he was doing a. Yeah, he was doing a 2A at that one point in his string, so he kept like doing jump and jump C. That was good.
Man, when he get the.
Yeah. Oh yeah. No, did you hear me whispering it? Like,
yeah,
always.
I felt it was coming.
Cause it's like Sam likes to do it. Cause, I mean, it's like an astro. Like with 2GB, the only time I need to bait it is like, or like the time he wants to do it is when he gets it. And you only get it when you have like under a certain amount of health or something. Kind of like, yeah. So I was like, oh, he's gonna do it. He's gonna do it. And it's really good because it's only 3 buttons. So you can just like see something and you do it. Oh, can't get it on.
Yeah.
Oh, you gotta flip it. You gotta flip it like that. Yeah.
All right.
That's the
fuck.
Dude, it's so hot.
Yeah, it's pretty warm.
Yeah, dude, we need some freaking rain. Like, it hasn't rained in like forever. We're in a pretty bad drought. But hopefully as winter comes up, it'll rain more.
Yeah. That's kind of like been my problem all day today, though. My execution's been off because of the weather.
Like, yeah, it is. I do hate it. Like, there's only like one fan in here too.
Yeah.
So it kind of sucks. All right, so we got Tari versus CT Warrior.
I don't know how this is gonna go.
Yeah, I actually think Tari sent him to losers earlier.
Oh, okay, all right.
Yeah, so this is like favored for Tari to win.
Right.
Nice. People gotta get used to that, like, when people do, like, an empty jump, like, low,
yeah.
You can't do, like, empty jump overhead, unless you're, like, Hilda or something, mm-hmm. You know, where you should do, like, the delayed jump save.
Yeah.
So, like, the only time empty jump low should ever hit you is if you shield it high, and it'll shield break you. So people gotta get used to, like, switch blocking that.
Yeah.
I mean, I definitely mess it up a lot, too.
Mm-hmm.
Nice, gets the first round there.
Yeah, sometimes you just, like, forget.
Yeah. The slices. Yeah, Yuzu is a pretty annoying character, honestly.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
She's kind of like, you just have to respect her, and over again, and then, like, wait for your turn.
Yeah, you have to. You can't get impatient.
Yeah, like, the only times I ever hit Tari, like, it's even scary. Like, you'd think, like, Merkava could, like, challenge her. Like, I can kind of challenge her. Like, after she wastes the slashes, I can kind of, like, do 5C and stuff.
Yeah.
But, like, you just have to, like, all the times I hit Tari was, like, when he went in too hard. Like, any other time he was doing nothing, nothing happened. Like, he was just, like, block and, like, nothing. Nice. Hits him out of jump start up there. Oh, he has the infinite worth. He's probably going to spend it on the next combo. Ooh.
That might be. Oh.
Oh, it drops it. Right. Oh, it's got infinite worth now.
That should be it.
Oh, no. Wait. Oh, wow.
It should have just.
Oh, man.
I wouldn't have went for the full combo there. I would have level 2. That's what I tried to do earlier, but I got 3C for whatever reason.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Alright, 1-0 Atari.
Yeah.
Two Warrior adapts here. Like, he is, like, from what I saw when he played for Zero Hour, he seemed, like, kind of over-aggressive.
Yeah.
Like, what I saw. Mm-hmm. So maybe he'll, like, change it up. Because, like, being over-aggressive versus, like, Yuzu is usually pretty bad.
Yeah.
Alright, but he's in there right now. Another thing about Yuzu, she doesn't really have any reversals at all.
Yeah.
She has, like, her counter, but that's not really, like, that good.
Exactly.
Nice, smash it out. Good match. Ooh, late text it. Ooh, he's going everywhere. Wait, so that little teleport thing where it's all, like, the little, like, yellow stuff?
Uh-huh.
Is that plus?
Oh, the Kuga? Yeah, that's like
no,
plus.
No, not Lin, for Yuzu.
Yuzu? Oh, I'm not sure.
Yeah, where she does like the teleport thing. I think it's plus. I remember I shielded it and I tried to mash, but didn't work out. I think it is.
Okay. Yeah, I know Kuga for sure.
Oh,
is
yeah,
plus.
Kuga is plus.
That move's so annoying to deal with.
Yeah. Alright, gotta block a mix up. Nice. Something I learned from fighting Toki.
I like this man.
Yeah, he's good. But something I learned is sometimes you gotta be like in this game actually. Like you gotta be willing to like take throws sometimes.
You have to.
It's weird, but whenever I like start mixing someone up, like that entry level mix up is throw bait for some reason as opposed to throw for most people. So and throw bait is the more damaging option. So like people gotta be a little more willing to like take the throw sometimes. Because it's definitely more less damaging.
Yeah.
Clark is dead.
He should be dead.
Oh,
a super does hella damage. Oh no,
oh,
it didn't kill. Interesting.
Oh super! No, why did he do his infinite worth? Oh, he might do his plus supers now.
Yeah, let's see.
Ooh. Oh my god, he made it his throw! No! Oh shit! Oh.
That move has a ton of recovery.
Good for Tari there.
Yeah.
Wow, Clark is dead right now.
Oh my, yeah.
Can we my get God. A camera on the body montage?
Poor Clark.
I felt sorry for him when he played earlier.
Yeah, it was pretty funny.
Yeah.
He actually beat it.
Alright, good stuff.
You know what? He actually beat somebody.
Who'd he beat?
He beat some guy named Patrick. He's some Oriole.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. He didn't really, like, he's kind of a little new to the game. But, like, he beat him with, like, doing the silliest stuff, I swear.
Was it with Gorda?
Yeah, No, that was versus Dasabro. He used Nanase versus that guy.
Oh, okay.
It was really funny. He did, like, you know Nanase's force function where she just does that big jump?
Yeah.
He, like, did jump, land, super. It was really funny.
Man.
Oh my god, he's so good.
He got those realistic mind games.
Alright, he's in the corner. Nice counter. It doesn't combo.
I sure hope he doesn't burst.
Nice. Oh, I was gonna punish that Kuga there.
That stuff's so light.
Yeah, it's the thing with the brown Kuga into dash is actually minus. So people gotta like mash there.
Yeah.
But you know, it's really fast now that people are used to it.
Mm.
Damn. I didn't expect C2 Warrior to be up like this, but it's good. Whoa, what the hell was that?
Yeah, I don't know.
Is that? I've never seen that move.
Me neither. Maybe her counter? I don't know.
Yeah.
Something.
I don't actually know what her force function is. Maybe it's that.
Yeah.
That's the meter. I don't know about that.
Yeah, I don't understand what that was about.
I don't know. I think he's dead.
Yeah, Clark's dead.
This is the point where we take pictures of him. Nice. Throws him. Finally. Wow, that did pretty good damage. Got a good setup. Oh! I think he tried to do the throw.
He
grabbed him out of it. Oh, is he going to spend it? Yeah. Nice. Tari, last game, last round.
next year. He is up in meter though.
Wow, what the hell?
That was pretty awesome.
Yeah, that was a really good call out. Very ballsy, but a good call out.
I didn't know you got a combo off of it too.
Me neither.
Nice, getting a good corner carry here. He's already presented throw like twice already, so maybe he might throw bait him next time. Oh, he tries to wake up and mash.
What was that? Wake up what now?
I think he tried to do wake up 5 here. Oh, he drops it! Oh my god, he got counter hit! That sucks.
Yeah. It's like next hit dies for either one.
This is really scary. Oh, I think he could have comboed off of that.
He could have. He could have like chain shifted.
Oh my god. Oh no! Not like this. That's the worst way to lose. Oh my god, what? What title?
Oh my god.
Infinite worth. Oh my god, he dropped it also. Are you serious?
What is even going on?
Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god, right there, I would have mashed change shift like no tomorrow. I would have pooped my pants.
I don't even know what to say. Yeah. Right there.
Jesus Christ, that was really close.
That was crazy. Me and Tari, or who? Blackout? Okay.
Good luck, Pain. I feel, dude, you haven't taken a single purple throw today. I feel so bad. Jesus, sorry. Yeah, no, I thought he was gonna combo into Infinite Worth.
Yeah, it literally should have just gone into, I think it was after that, it was supposed to be like 2C?
2C Infinite Worth, that's it. Yeah, something like that.
Oh, actually, that drops on Yuzu mid-screen.
Oh. Okay, well, who knows? He probably do like the right combo.
Yeah, he would do something. I think he said it was No, sorry. Okay, the non-2C version drops on Yuzu mid-screen. Oh, the 2C version combos.
Right,
there you go.
That's probably what he would have done. Oh, I'll take that money.
Man, that was
Dang, you've just been having close matches all day.
I have had a lot of close matches, unfortunately. Well, yeah. Until I got here,
matches, though. I feel like those are the matches that train you as a fighting game player.
When I got on stream, I had close matches.
Yeah.
Before that, it was okay. Yeah.
I see. But yeah, I love those close matches. It really tests like your like nerves.
Yeah. I can't believe I missed that combo. I should have done the other super.
Yeah.
I can't believe he missed his combo. Oh my god.
Yeah, that's what happened. That's tournament, man. Like, I'm not. That shit doesn't even surprise me anymore.
That first match. You know, I won the first match too. We also both failed our combos at the end of that first match's last round.
Yeah.
It's unfortunate.
Damn, Barista talking shit.
Do what?
Damn, what a dick. What a meanie.
Oh, Bell, please.
All right, we got Blackout versus Pain.
Oh, wait, Clark actually passed out? Is that what happened?
He fell down and Young like picked him up.
Wow, where is he? Is he on the sofa?
I think so. That's like the drunk place to go.
Man, Clark was so dead.
It's like the drunk rehabilitation place. You lay on the sofa.
That was like not even funny. Like he was like, I can't believe he kept drinking.
I know. No. Dude was messed up. Ron was giving him more stuff.
Wait, is that what was happening?
I think, I don't know. I'm going to ask him later. If people gave him more drinks, that'd be messed up.
There was one point where he was playing, or he was sitting there, he was running the brackets.
Yeah.
And then he lost the tablet, and then he just like got confused.
Oh my god.
That's why James took over. James took the tablet from him after that.
Yeah. No, something people should remember. If you're going to drink at a tournament, make sure you're not the person running the brackets.
Yeah. But his drunk Nana say was amazing.
It was. Oh man, you missed a great.
You saw
that match, right?
I saw some of it. I'm so sad it wasn't on stream.
Oh man, he did like force function, empty jump super. Oh my god.
Yeah, max force function.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Clark's the best.
The people on stream missed out, unfortunately.
Yeah, and then he picked Gordo versus David.
Oh yeah.
And he like did like start of the match like quadruple slide. Nice getting purple here. Doesn't really need it though. He already has the purple.
If it wasn't for overheads, Clark would probably have done much better.
Yeah, he's like, oh, shit's cheap, man.
He can't react to overheads when he's drunk.
Nice.
Well, Payne's doing really well here.
No, I feel Hilda's like a mid-tier character, right?
She's So she's like a mid to low tier character, apparently.
But yeah, she's like
she has good matchups against the top three.
That's, yeah, it's like, it's kind of like Dhalsim. Like, Dhalsim is very good for Shotos.
Oh, is that how it works?
Like, historically, he's been very good for Shotos. But like, Dhalsim has like a lot of bad matchups. The example I'm trying to point out is like, these zoning type characters, is like, they'll be good versus like a certain kind of character.
Yeah.
And in some cases, those characters will be very strong.
Yeah, so like, Hilda's like ability to control the mid-screen space actually denies all of Volsing's movement options.
Yeah, because he can't run. Yeah. He can only assault.
I think probably the top three that does best against her might be Merkava.
Yeah.
Because I think you have like stretchy arms and stuff, so you have better range.
Yeah, exactly.
Is that it? I think that's it.
The thing I love in the Hilda matchup is I love doing dash C. Because if she does anything like 2C, 5B, 5C.
Oh, you flip over
it. You just flip right over
it. But if she does 5C, you get hit.
The little thing. Yeah. But it, that has a lot of startup. Like, in a range where, like...
The non-charge version isn't that long.
I see.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's usually... Yeah, what's up? Nah, I'm good. I'm not trying to tech throws with BC.
I have no idea. I did this so many times.
Yeah.
I killed myself in Guilty Gear by trying to shield with the punch button.
I think the thing that translates from Marvel to anime games for me the most is I was actually playing Marvel earlier, so I always try to push block stuff. I'm just like, go away. I'm like, wait, they're not going anywhere.
Shielding class push block though, which is nice.
Yeah, it's true. It's kind of like that.
Green shield has a lot of push blocks.
Yeah, it does.
Or guard shield if you want to be technical.
Nice. Just skewering him.
I mean, it's working.
Yeah, skewer, like, wow. It's not gonna zone you forever. It is minus, assuming you're not using the B version. It's more like he's jumping back. This is to, like, stop him from getting in.
Yeah. Oh, that was a nice guard crush. Or a grid crush.
Yeah. Super. Oh, nice. Oh, no. Yeah, this is hard.
Yeah, like, getting in against this is really difficult. I'm surprised he didn't just skewer him there.
Yeah, honestly. He actually shook his head. He's trying to whiff punish that, probably.
So, I actually was watching a Wolfsting play against Hilda. I can't remember who it was. They were messing around. But he just did, he was just sitting there blocking, and then just, like, when he was out of range of Hilda's normals, he just did the wall slam.
Oh, wow.
It looked so funny.
That's so funny. Nice, Blackout finally gets a hit here.
Yeah, Blackout gets his in.
Oh,
he misses the throw.
I don't know if that would have worked though. He was still in block stun.
Yeah, he was definitely still in block stun. That would be a complete yellow throw.
Yeah, maybe he was trying to bait like a shield or something.
Maybe. I wouldn't shield against Wald though, not like that.
Yeah. See, the thing, I actually like shielding versus Wald. Like, I generally, when I'm in a range where I have to guess like a soul jump C, I will shield at first. Because the empty jump, like command grab or whatever, that's the bigger read. Like, that's the more committing
thing. Oh, no. So what I do is when I think there's a range where he can't throw me.
Oh. No, that, oh yeah, that's it.
Oh, is that it?
Yeah, I guess I'm playing.
Oh, yeah, okay. Go.
All right.
We need someone else on commentary. James, you want to commentate? Alright, so up next we have Vineeth versus Philip. This is winners what? David. Oh, this is winners finals? Alright. Really? God damn it. Alright. Yeah.
And I like won by timeout of a fireball on like shit fairly. And then there's another game I was gonna lose and I did like
DQ me from the rest of my matches. Yeah, just DQ me. I just wanted to when I saw the first match, I was like, I gotta play this and I'm done. Sloth, how did you not know she was yelling elbow? Two gig combo versus Apology Man. Yo, Vineeth. What was your name before Apology Man?
Wall Jump Man.
Wall Jump Man. Oh, really?
Yeah. So it's like my secret identity.
Oh, that's hella good.
No, don't do it, don't do it. It's a secret identity. I can expose you. Okay. Divide.
Is this button test, or are they actually... Is this the actual match? I guess it is. I can't tell what they're doing. This does not look like a match. Yeah, Vineet is trying to play Marvel. Alright, here we go. This is the actual match. Yo, David, you want a mic?
Hey, I guess all we right. Can't get anybody else to sit in here.
Not right now. I think most of the other guys who could commentate are getting food.
Yeah.
So. All right, so this is Vineet versus Philip for Winners Finals, he said, right?
Yes, this is the Winners Finals. All 2 right. Gig has the momentum here, has Vineet in the corner.
The setup is so big. I swear, there's like nothing you can do if you don't have a DP or meter.
Yeah, man.
Oh, he gets the overhead.
Jesus Christ.
I know, right?
It's like, what do you do?
Did you know Carmine off of the trap? Trap is his best starter. Did you know that?
No, I didn't realize it was his best starter.
It's actually his best start. So in the corner, if you get hit by trap and he has like 150 meter or something,
yeah.
He does a full combo into bail off. It does 6.8k.
What a great character.
It's amazing. That's why the second round is so terrifying against him when he has a trap. Like, the first round's not that bad because he usually doesn't have that much meter, but the second round, you know.
Yeah.
He's just sitting on that meter.
Oh, now this round is very much in Vineet's favor.
Yeah, Vineet has his little, like, hand Oki here. Oh, there you go. The other way around.
TK hands is hella funny.
TK hands is plus one.
Yeah, it's like super good. It confirms into a full combo.
Yeah. All right, here. Now it's 2 gigs. He gets the corner knockdown, trap placement.
My favorite Merkava confirm. And
Oh, wow. That was such a crazy match.
Confirm and, you know, safe on block is 2A TK hands.
Oh, that's pretty good.
That's
I don't
the
know
best.
If he's seeing what Vineet is doing.
Yeah.
It's, like, so hard to deal. Like, I'm not used to reacting to Merkava's options, right? So like from my end, I can't remember to shield or counter the things I need to counter.
Uh-huh.
So what Vineet does is hilarious. I think it's overhead, like 3C.
Yeah.
Shake the baby on block, cancel into TK hands. Or not TK, into rising hands. Into
okay.
Rising hands.
Okay.
That's plus one.
That's pretty cool.
It's a completely safe block screen. Like, what do? You have to shield the last hit of the hands. Vineet takes that back. Vineet is pretending to be Merkava. Vineet is pretending to be Merkava. Round start, run under Greasy, or was that Dapsy? I think it was Dapsy. I'm bad at identifying the different Merkava overheads, because they all look the same.
Sugig has all the momentum here.
Oh, there's a trap hit. Look at this damage.
Oh my god.
Look at this damage. Look at this damage. Meterless 4.1k, man.
Wow.
Oh, high counter. Jumps, charge jumps the hit.
That's a good way to catch
Flight.
Merkava.
Yeah, I think it just beats Flight.
It looks like it would.
Oh, that's it. I think that might just be game. If Philip doesn't drop this combo, this might just be game.
Let's see this.
Oh, he got it.
2 gigs generally has, like, immaculate execution.
Boom. That's the end of the game. Welcome to Trap.
Philip, you didn't drop the combo.
What is this game?
That's such a scary setup. I hate the trap. That was interesting. Run under Merkava, assault jump B, I think.
Yeah, I'm not sure if you could run under that.
Yeah, I didn't know you could run under that, so I'm not sure he did either.
Yeah.
All right. Oh.
Full corner carry.
Dude, I can't believe this carried from like one side of the screen to the other.
Basically full corner carry.
Yeah. All right, Vinny flying out. Oh, he gets the dive. Oh no. That's not a. What would you call that move? The wing thing.
It's some know. Dive. Of
some sort of dive, right? I don't know. Oh no, Vinny held shield for too long.
Bridge break.
Oh, he gets this hit. This could give him the momentum he needs. Oh.
He probably wanted to do like command throw or something.
Yeah, or just throw. Oh, he does break that throw. Oh!
I guess he was trying to bait out like
he was
probably a throw,
I think. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's actually a really scary option. Oh, that's it. Philip takes it. That's actually a really scary option, the immediate TK dive. All right, I gotta play Pain again.
All right. Let's see. We got Tari versus Pain.
Of course he was mashing. Whatever. Yeah. Man, I was pretty sad about that. I was safe. He always does, what is it called? He does a little slime thing that's plus.
Uh-huh.
And you can do a dash C over the little follow-up that he always does. I did that, but I messed it up.
Oh.
I was, like, saving that. Oh, well.
Oh, okay. Guess they're just button checking.
Yeah.
Oh, I need to change these names. There we go. This is Loser Semis. You'll be playing the winner of this, Vinny?
Yeah. Oh, well, good shot to 2GIG. He definitely played well. Should have knew he would do throw baits. The thing, I was talking to him earlier about, like, it's just like, you want to take the throw. Like, he has this like that's like 7K combo. Like I was talking like, dude, I'll take throws all day. So I had this like meta, right? I'm like, oh, I'm just gonna tech throws because he's just gonna throw me because I told him that. But then he just went for the throw bait.
Oh,
he mostly wanted to go for it just so he could show off the combo. Yeah, what's up? It's on me this time. Is he on the couch? Okay, that's like the drunk person rehabilitation couch.
Tari has Pain in the corner here. Man, Yuza does a lot of damage.
Yeah. Yeah, she cuts you up. Gotta respect her crab.
Actually, nice teleport chain shift. Really solid movement option for Yuzu.
Yeah.
So Pain in this round is really trying to out neutral Tari. It's working so far.
Wow, are you serious?
Hey, just
did you see that? Like the rain, like didn't hit him.
Yeah.
He dodged rain.
It's hella good.
That's pretty amazing.
Wow.
I don't know if the rain is like random trajectory or not.
Oh, that should have like tied it up. Atari dropped the combo.
Yeah, he would have comboed into infinite.
And this is
and he drops it again.
Oh, no, Atari, please.
Oh, crap, I shield it. Oh, my God, Atari. Atari keeping his head in the game.
Drops it.
Yeah.
Pain gets the mash.
Ooh, there's the plus thing. Yeah. No, this is mix up. He's kind of taking his time blocking. He knows not to press buttons. He knows when his turn is. Oh, wow. Teleports. Whoa. It's going
Atari
everywhere.
With the teleport shenanigans.
Yeah, I thought he would have teleported a chain shift because he was definitely not getting Vorpal.
Yeah.
Now Pain has Vorpal now. Tar's got to go in somehow. Maybe like cut him. Wow, run up.
Hey, and he got Vorpal too.
Nice. Yeah, at the very last second. That was crazy. Wow, I thought that was a safe jump. Oh, well. Oh, wow. Combo into... No, he drops it. He dropped... Wait, what? That overhead didn't... Like, whip. That was weird. Oh, my God. Tar
this
blocking.
Match is kind of like a drop montage.
Yeah, I know. Skewer. V-Skewer's plus though. He's got to go in. He has like 12 seconds. Oh!
Oh, my God.
Oh. He might be able to infinite worth and kill him.
I think he can.
Or double super? No, it didn't work.
Is that enough?
No. He has to mix him up somehow. Oh, my God.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
My the throw
God.
Took too long. He should have just hit anything that hit.
Wait, why didn't you combo into infinite worth? Wouldn't that have done more? Huh? Oh, it does less, I see. So, apparently the combo route he did more. Oh, but, okay, it was a button check.
Wait, did he have the wrong config?
No, I think he had the right config. He's just kind of trying to get comfortable or something.
Okay.
Maybe his like AD wasn't like registering. I don't know.
Maybe.
Weird. Dang. That was Tari's game. That was really clever, like what Pain did. But oh man, if Tari didn't do run up throw and he just punished him, he would have won.
Yeah, just like hit 5C or something.
5A or anything. He just needed one hit.
Oh, Pain just going in, mashing 2A. Looks like Tari's being really passive here.
Yeah.
He definitely had some chances a little earlier.
Oh. Wow, that dodge was sick. I thought he was going to get punished.
Oh, excellent teleport there.
I think he tried to anti-air the teleport the other way, but he didn't. Oh, why did he hit a button? He should have stopped at 5A.
Gets a reset. Hey, all the resets.
Oh, wow. Oh, okay. Oh, but he did it without Vorpal. He's grid broken now. Oh, my God. They're both grid broken.
Grid broken. Tari trying to sit on his health here and time Pain out.
Yeah, he kind of gave up.
Pain just kind of gave up.
1-0. Pain.
Excellent damage here.
Yep.
I figured I would break 4K, but guess not.
Thank you. late throw. It's very interesting.
Oh, he could have.
Alright, just block in. Because, oh, that was my 7. He could, I think that was probably what he was waiting for. He became a little too passive there.
Yeah.
Oh,
no.
No, there's one more. There's another round. Yeah. Damn, Tari already accepting defeat.
Man, Tari's matches are always, like, so close.
I know, right? Like, all of his matches on stream have been so close. No! What? Whoa. Oh, no, he wins. Wait, what the hell?
He fairly consistently wins in tourney. It's just that it's never really super convincing.
Yeah, I guess. Oh, no, he whiffs the slash.
Oh, well, he's trying to counter it. That's kind of interesting.
And that may actually be it. Should be.
Yeah.
Yep.
All right.
Yep.
Guess I got to play pain now.
All right. We're moving into Losers Finals, guys. Apology Man versus Pain. Let's see. Oh wait, no, somebody else is handling it.
Alright, I'm out again. Is my food here? I guess not. Alright, so this is for Losers Finals. This is still 2 out of 3, yes?
Yes.
All right.
Only Grand Finals is 3 out of 5.
Alright, we're doing 2 out of 3 all the way across until Grand Finals. Button check. We are button checking. You guys came back from Popeyes. Were you around for Clark passing out?
I sponsored Clark tonight.
Did you actually, were you here when he actually passed out though?
Yeah, he used my backpack as a pillow.
He was just gone. Alright. No, I have food coming from Wingstop, so. Whenever they actually finish eating over there and come back. Actually, since they're button checking, I'm gonna grab a drink. I'll be right back.
As far as I know, Clark is still passed out. I can't really step away far enough to see the couch. And here we have Apology Man Merkava versus Pain Hilda.
I have returned.
So Tari, you were in the other room just now. Is Clark still passed out?
I did not see him getting up, so I'm assuming he is indeed still passed out.
Okay. Because Sean was asking in the chat here.
Yeah, I think Clark is just dead. I'm sorry, guys. Clark is gone for the foreseeable future.
Yeah, he was done. He was already, like, super tipsy, and then he just kept drinking.
Yeah. I don't really know what to say about that.
Drink responsibly, folks.
Yeah, yes, please.
That is the moral of the story today. It looks like a... Apology Man can't really get anything started here.
Startup is like 28 frames or something. It's like... If he does what?
Pain with excellent blocking.
A lot. You can slash it. If he does 5cc, or if he does charge 5c back spike, it's gap. You can't do anything. If he does charge 5c into back spike, you can't do anything. But I mean, that's really risky by itself, so...
Pain going in, landing a charge JC.
Pain running his way back through the bracket here.
playing pretty well now.
Beneath gets his reversal super here. Going to get some pressure going. Corner hit. Oh, nice.
Pain decides to sacrifice his grid.
Yeah, he sacrificed all his meter too. Jeez.
Yeah.
He really wanted out.
And I don't think that's a bad idea. But no, Beneath just got right back in.
Yeah, I think it's actually pretty beneficial for Hilda to get out of the corner, but
it's like a new in CT. It's like the moment
burst.
We get in burst.
Yeah, as soon as they touch you, just burst, go away.
Yeah, man.
It was the best. This is the funniest combo, by the way. Oh my god, it didn't kill. The last hit of the hand didn't reach. That's hella funny.
But I don't think this will kill.
Oh, it might.
No, it won't.
Oh, it will!
It does.
Oh, he CS'd it. He CS'd. I didn't realize he had CS. Oh, that's hella good. Pain knowing how to optimize his super combo.
I would expect no less of him.
Yeah, so I think Pain out of the top three, this is the hardest matchup for Hilda.
I would believe it.
Yeah.
I believe it.
Because I think Merkaba has the best options for avoiding Hilda.
Yeah.
And like beating out her space, you know what I mean?
Yeah, she at full screen doesn't really cover like all the way like in front of her in the air.
Yeah.
That's where I like to sit in the Hilda matchup also.
Oh,
as
yeah.
As Batista.
Well, Batista Hilda sounds silly.
I do like jump back and then shoot a ball.
It's a hit. Yeah, so for people who don't know, Shake the Baby is actually a hit throw. So if you're blocking, you just block it. However, because it's a hit throw, if you block it, he can special cancel it into safe specials, which is sad. Good blocking from Beneath here. Gets hit by Dash Seat. Blocks the overhead. He has to do something faster there if he wants to push a button.
Yep.
Loser finals. Philip. What? Oh, I forgot we paid money to enter this tournament.
Oh yeah, we did.
I totally forgot. I should have tried really hard to get third so I could get my money back.
Yeah.
I'm like one of those. We're all poverty. I want my money back. I know. I was saying third place should get all of the foreign currency. Yeah, so I don't know how many people actually entered this tournament, but it was a $5 entry fee. I think we have a pretty good pool size, actually.
I think it was like 30 or so.
So 5 times 30, we have a bunch of like money in the pool, in the pot.
Where does it indicate how many total? 31.
31 entries.
31.
That's a pretty good amount of money.
Did you want the mic, Judge? Because you're sitting there?
Judge, did you want the mic? Do you want the other mic, or...?
Okay. Right. Sure, I guess I'll pass it over.
So we have 130-something entrants, or I mean 150-something dollars then?
I'm surprised there wasn't a third mic set up.
We don't have it here. We just don't bring it.
I understand. No reason to have too many people talking.
Yeah, it's just for the commentator section.
Yeah. Just want to give a shout out to Popeyes, powering us up for the night. Thank you, Popeyes.
So we have here the grand finals. It's going to be between Philip and Pain.
So Pain coming from losers. Did Philip knock him into loser earlier?
I knocked him into losers.
You knocked him into losers, and then...
Yeah, and then I lost to him in losers.
He got his run back.
Yeah.
That happened to you last tournament as well.
Yeah, I knocked Philip into losers last tournament and got knocked out by him in losers.
Man, it's a curse.
No, well, I'll get past it eventually.
You'll get... Like, I believe in you. Use your power, man. One day, we'll conquer. We'll conquer Dogfight / Caliburst. I'm excited. All right, here we go. They shook hands.
All right, it looked like they're just going straight into it here. Or, yes, there we go. Oh, wow, that is really bad for Hilda.
Carmine.
It was a very ballsy decision, just running up as Hilda, trying to get into close range against Carmine. Carmine excels at the close range.
I guess he's trying to exploit his 2A.
Oh, no, he did a run-up dash move, but Carmine moved forward as well, so the dash move just completely whiffed.
Yeah, the spacing was just a little off.
Spacing was a little unfortunate there. Tegan trying to bait things with his trap as always.
He's in a bad spot. Oh, he gets out. Perfect.
Hilda's buttons are actually decent against Carmine Pressure because when she pushes him out, she can equal his normal range.
Okay.
So like her normals are slow.
Drink? Orange Fonda. Orange Fonda.
So, yeah, her moves are normally sort of slow, but at that range, they're actually not bad, because she excels at that sort of mid-range, right?
Yeah, that mid-poke.
Oh, this is going to hit.
Oh, nice combo.
Yeah, Carmine's Infinite Worth is guaranteed to hit you if you push a button in the sky, pretty much.
Okay.
Unless you have an invulnerable super in the sky.
I mean, I think Akatsuki can counter it because he's got a frame zero counter in the air.
So Akatsuki can counter it. The timing is weird, but give me 1 second here.
Okay. Tari taking a phone call mid-commentary. That's the next level.
Do they have root beer? Park, right?
Nice conversion.
Yeah, if they have, I'll take that. All right, thanks.
Alright, so yeah, Carmine's super is or Infinite Worth just tracks wherever you are in the sky.
It doesn't hit like kinda like Aegis's 2B?
No, actually.
Or does it like one hit follow you wherever you go?
One hit follows you.
Okay.
It's
very deceiving, the animation.
It is really deceiving. Like, all of those are hits. Don't get me wrong, like, all of those are hits. But his super pretty much is just this, like, wave that goes outward, and if you're in that wave, you get hit.
Correct. Okay.
It's not quite like Aegis, because Aegis has, like, a clear progression to it.
Yeah. Ooh, chain shift into 5A. Totally calls out the normal coming out. Stuffs it.
Yeah. So the way, there are, I think, three, four characters that can actually super through it in the sky, or can get past it if they're in the sky and they push the button. Akatsuki.
Akatsuki is one of them.
Yuzu with meter. Seth with meter.
Yuzu can dodge it if she's in her
stance. If she's in stance.
Yeah, it depends what stance she used.
But generally, if you're not in stance or if you did a slash, you have to cancel into the flip super. You have to late cancel into flip super. The nice thing about that is if he does do that and you late cancel into flip super, you actually just punish him.
That's kind of cool.
The downside is if you try to teleport, which you can, it's pretty cool. You can see teleport to get past the arc. But as it turns out, there's this little puddle around his feet when he does his Infinite Worth, and they turn into spikes.
Oh, God.
And you just land on it, and it knocks you over.
Can you? Oh, yeah.
I mean, you don't take full damage, but you can't punish him.
I imagine you tried dodging it.
No, because like it's active the entire time. You just land on it.
Yeah.
It's really weird. If you react early enough, maybe. I haven't tried.
Yeah.
I'll be honest.
Oh no, Pain dropping the mid-screen combo just picks the wrong button.
Oh wow, just a straight run-up throw. That was pretty meaty. Nice kill off. I think he... Oh no. I was going to say I think he could have gotten away with using his anti-air there, but I guess he didn't want to risk letting 2GIG just do the extra man throw on
the air. I think 2GIG's conditioning him because he did the empty jump block in the last chain shift, and he wanted to see what he could get off of this one. And...
What a strange trade. Good throw.
I feel like 2GIG's Carmine is just so fast that if you do trade and you're not ready for it, he gets up and he's in your face. And
no, trading with Carmine, like you're saying, is really, really dangerous.
Yeah,
like,
it's essentially a lose-lose.
Yeah. It's really unfortunate Pang hasn't been blocking those overheads. Like, it's very important that you block them. They are another way that Carmine can combo into a 6K combo, so...
Got it. Yeah, it's a pretty good starter for him.
Yeah, it's pretty good. Not as good as Trap, but close.
Yeah.
He still gets, like, 6K off of it.
I know, 2GIG, he really wants to land the almost 7K on stream.
Yeah, 2GIG got one earlier on Beneath.
He was hurting. He like, I could feel it, because he said he came to me and said, yo, I dropped it. I didn't get to show the world. he really wants to. He's hungry.
If he gets all the grid when he does it... He can get quite a lot of damage.
Yeah.
He went to Batista.
He wants the flash kick. He needs it.
Having a DP is really useful in this matchup.
It puts another level of depth to Carmine's Oki.
Yeah, having a DP is really useful in this matchup. I think also if she has Vorpal, and he's doing trap Oki, she can ADP CS and assault over the trap. I think she might be able to, I think it might move her far enough horizontally and vertically to get out of the trap range.
Okay.
But I mean, that's a really like gimmicky answer, but you know.
Yeah. Hey, you know what? Nothing's gimmicky if it works. That's not true.
Yeah, I was going to say. I think it still counts as a gimmick.
I just made that up.
It's just a good gimmick.
Can you define a gimmick for me?
Something that shouldn't work if people know that it exists.
All right. Oh, gosh.
Or I guess the other way of putting it is things that work once.
Things that work once. Fool me once.
Yeah. If it works once and not any time after that, it's a gimmick.
Fool me once. Okay. Well, after that, it becomes a mix-up. Oh, no. Batista.
I mean, technically, that's sort of true. That's why Taker's mix-up is all gimmicks.
I don't know. You watch Tiku Taker, right?
Yeah, dude, no, that guy's scary.
Oh, that air overdrive.
Confirm.
Yeah, it wasn't looking too good for the Batista a minute ago. Now it's looking
much better.
Yeah.
She's evened out the life lead here.
She needs
blocks
to, like...
the DP. That DP, by the way, for people who don't know, that thing is plus.
It's only plus if only the blood
if
hits.
If only the blood hits, but it is still plus.
Yeah.
I don't know if Payne was trying to be cool there or if he just happened to CS at that point, but he could have CS'd through the throw, which would have been hilarious.
Oh, my gosh. Oh.
Last chance.
He's got to make a move.
Last chance. Oh, no. Wow.
And that is
all right,
the
Philip just takes it. Payne looking really sad over there.
I just want to put it out there that Philip had eaten his Popeyes already, and Payne had not.
Philip already ate?
Yeah.
Oh, Payne, what is this?
I know you guys watched Payne receive Popeyes on stream. That was like the best moment of the night for me.
But Philip already ate
Popeyes. Yeah, Philip, he got his power up, man. They didn't want to save it for the next game. They wanted to go eat. Unfair advantage. Just
Philip. Yo, Philip. Philip, 2GIG. You want to say a word as the winner?
Here, No. All right. All right, here we go. All right, take a seat. So I just want to say thank you for winning the tournament because I don't think anyone's aware of it, but I sponsored 2GIG with Popeyes tonight.
Yeah, he did.
He gave me cash, and I didn't use it.
Right,
you're
now
my boy.
I have that $5.
You have that?
Well, no, from the winnings.
Oh, yeah, we got the $5 box. This is
that's not a $5 box.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
This is the box they put the $5 meal in, the $5 big box.
Mine's a bit different.
What's that?
Mine's a bit different, so whatever.
Are you hurting my feelings?
No.
I don't understand what you're trying to tell me.
Okay. Yeah. So, I think Carmine is actually probably the most underrated character in the entire game.
Mm-hmm.
I think his damage output...
It's good.
Without meter and with meter is just insane.
Yeah, you control the Vorpal pretty well, too, when you play. When I watch you play...
I think that's actually the most important part about this game.
Mm-hmm.
If you have... I've noticed from, like, watching JP match vids, most of the time, the person who wins the first cycle usually wins the round.
Mm-hmm.
So,
yeah, they have a huge meter advantage. Yeah. They got the DPS or the damage advantage.
Yeah.
Sorry, wild term. They got damage advantage, you know. And Carmine, like when he trades, he tends to come out on top because you go back to neutral with a puddle on the ground usually, which is huge for you because you can, you know.
Yeah, the BDP is really good.
Yeah, dude. The what's the? Do you know the frame advantage on it?
Somewhere from plus 10 to plus 20.
So
somewhere around
don't
there.
Push buttons is what you're saying.
You can usually like try to jump out if I'm like,
oh, that's
far enough.
That's
away.
A hard call out because you're 2BB, I think it is.
No, 2C.
2C? Like it picks people up out of the air.
If you're like up back, I usually don't have enough time to dash and catch you. Mm. But
oh yeah, his run speed is really fast too.
Yeah.
Like he closes the gap like you weren't paying attention, he's in your face.
Yeah. The only problem with it is that, well, I mean, most dashes are kind of slow to start up, but mm-hmm. I think it's slightly slower, but his dash speed compensates for it really well.
Yeah, it's like just watching you play that part of the matchup where you have to really close the space. Like, when you close the space against Tilda, she looked helpless.
Oh, yeah, it's just a lot of dash block.
Yeah, it's total.
Yeah, that matchup's actually Well, I think it's in Karma's favor. It's pretty hard not to lose that matchup.
Well, what is Carmine ranked in tiers? Is he, like, even to Hilt or lower?
From what I've seen, like, the tier list I've seen, at least, Carmine's usually rated B, and I don't think it's B at all.
Mm-hmm.
And usually Hilda's around was like a B tier also, but sometimes an A.
I saw someone like rated an A with the new characters. The new characters
right
pushed
now,
her up.
I think our top three is Gordo, Merkava, Waldstein.
Okay.
And then I think actually Carmine and Batista are like under those.
Okay. What do you like? So you're kind of rearranging the tier list to. Okay. Yeah. I mean, isn't Eltonum like rated like A or A plus? Or
I mean, it might just be personal bias, just because I think that matchup is kind of okay against Carmine. Like, I don't actually feel scared against that character.
Yeah.
Like,
I mean, you're 2 gigabyte combo. Who are you afraid of? You've won all, like, how many tournaments have you won since O'Neill was released?
I won the first one, and then I went, like, 1-2 in the second one.
Mm-hmm.
And then.
Don't mean esports yet, come on!
Yo, all right, okay. Yo, he's the highest making $0 earner on esports.
Actually, I won money today.
You won? So. He won money today. He's no longer amateur. He's a professional. He won money. Oh, we're talking about 2GB's esports career. He was the highest earning $0 on some forum. It was pretty good. What game are we switching to? Is that P4, the new one?
We are switching to Persona.
Okay.
And we have the same commentators because we are cheap.
Cool. Sweet. I haven't played...